Home southbound lanes of the Daniel Carter Beard Bridge remain closed right now as investigators work to figure out the cause of that massive fire from Friday.
And today, many drivers got their first taste of the new commute. WLWT News 5's Danielle Dindak is live tonight with new information from all kinds of officials. Hi there, Danielle.
Yeah, hi there, Mike. I can tell you that this closure is really causing a lot of headaches for drivers. So right now I'm standing at the intersection of Pete Rose Way and Broadway, and I do want to have you take a look behind me and around me so you can get a sense of all this traffic down here. So this is all leading to the Taylor Southgate Bridge, and that is just one of the detours people can take going to Kentucky. It's truly been bumper to bumper ever since we got out here 2 hours ago. Not a lot of patience out here, a lot of beeping we are hearing, but this is all happening at the same time as crews are working to fully open the bridge.
The play structure here was heavily involved in fire.
Cincinnati Assistant Fire Chief Matt Flagler.
The fire actually extended up and deformed the beams.
Walks us through the damage.
That joint has plastic, rubber, synthetic materials in it of some sort. That was actively burning.
He's referring to Friday morning's inferno at the Daniel Carter Beard Big Mac Bridge on 471. The mayhem started around 3:30 in the morning when the playground beneath went up in flames.
What in the world? That is ridiculous.
That blaze blackened the bridge, melted and warped beams. Three will have to be replaced. And that's not all. Here's Kathleen Fuller with ODOT.
We also have a sign truss that is on the bridge that has to be replaced, and also the decking will have to be replaced.
While contractors work on designs, crews sift through the rubble. Among them, a robotic dog went to work surveying the damage.
We're using those to help capture imaging for us that can get into the tight corners and the different aspects of the bridge so that we can use that in the design.
Investigators are still working to determine the cause of that massive fire that closed down all southbound lanes and one northbound lane.
The people who have to drive it daily, yeah, that's going to suck.
Jessica Horn is one of those people, getting her first taste of the traffic impact Monday morning.
It's definitely heavier traffic. It's crazy. I mean, I feel like we just had a fire shutting down 75, and now we have 471 shut down.
Now, what's happening behind me is really only going to get worse because tonight at 7, Jelly Roll is performing at a sold-out Heritage Bank Arena. You're seeing a lot of fans head over to the arena for that. Now, one last thing I do want to mention quickly is the timeline for when that bridge is supposed to reopen is supposed to come out sometime later this week. Of course, we'll continue to update you on any new developments. Reporting live tonight, Danielle Dindak, WLWT News 5.
All right.